What a game. Oh, my gosh. What a way to start the week. Congratulations.
As you probably already know, this is Emma Boettcher, the Chicago librarian who ended Jeopardy phenom James Holzhauer's relentless 32-game win streak, stopping him just short of Ken Jennings' previous single take-home record, $2.52 million. She also had a fun fact of her own up her sleeve.
Emma Boettcher, this young lady is a librarian from Chicago who did her master's paper on our show?
That's right, Alex.
Tell me about it.
I ran a series of text mining experiments to see if a computer could predict how difficult a clue was.
Boettcher's 2016 research paper didn't necessarily win her the perfect game, however. Her depth of knowledge, buzzer-beating skills, and accomplished strategy saw to that.
You know, I think I gotta make it a true daily double.
15,200.
And of course, this is not the first time someone tapped into the power of computing to win one of America's longest-running game shows.
Hello, 77,147.
But Boettcher's unassuming piece of personal trivia speaks to another phenomenon, one in which we ourselves are already starting to merge with artificially intelligent machines. Boettcher used the extensive J archive of Jeopardy episodes to analyze over 22,000 clues.
Based on things like how long it was, what words were in the clue, what the syntax was, and if it had any audiovisual elements in it.
And what did you discover?
That it's very hard to do.
The challenges of machine learning have long been tied to games as a testbed for computer intelligence. At first, it was chess.
Chess for thousands of years has been, you know, something that we've used to measure intelligence.
So it's thought of as kind of the mental decathlon, so to speak.
In 1997, IBM demonstrated the chess-playing power of AI when their Deep Blue computer used brute force calculations to defeat the greatest chess grandmaster in history, Garry Kasparov.
Yes, to begin with, we started, so I think something too undoable happened.
And when Ken Jennings' record 74-game run on Jeopardy,
Ken, what is Stella?
Inspired IBM to create Watson in 2008, the supercomputer harnessed the power of natural language processing in order to defeat two of the game show's most successful contestants at the time. More recently, Google DeepMind's AlphaGo beat the world's best Go player, Kerjia, in 2017, this time exploiting neural networks and deep learning to calculate the astronomical number of possible outcomes in the game.
对我来说就是围棋上帝的一个存在，就是碾压一切的就是存在。
Its next iteration, AlphaGo Zero, was even more formidable.
AlphaGo Zero doesn't use any human data whatsoever. Instead, what it has to do is learn for itself completely from self-play. After around 40 days, we found that it had actually defeated all previous versions of AlphaGo to become the strongest Go program in the world.
As artificial intelligence develops at this exponential rate, we seem to be at an inflection point where we are learning as much from the algorithm as it did from us in the first place. We no longer need to teach the AI how to play the game, it's teaching itself.
In a short space of time, AlphaGo Zero has understood all of the Go knowledge that has been accumulated by humans, and sometimes it's chosen to actually go beyond that and come up with something which the humans hadn't even discovered in this time period.
Undoubtedly, there's value for us here, but our relationship with AI has evolved. We are two entities learning a new language together, and this brings with it new challenges. Just as the linguist Louise Banks warns in the film Arrival.
Are they using a game to converse with their heptapods?
Why?
Well, let's say that I taught them chess instead of English. Every conversation would be a game, every idea expressed through opposition, victory, defeat, you see the problem. If all I ever gave you was a hammer.
Everything's a nail.
And so perhaps the most telling detail of Boettcher's Jeopardy win might not be the perfect game she played, but instead the underlying theme of a thesis paper, human-computer interaction.